Hello, my name is Jason Johnson. Thank you for watching my videos. This video is going to cover the Raptor flowchart-based programming. We're going to look at example 5.1, simply writing numbers. This program segment repeatedly inputs a number from the user and displays that number until the user enters a zero, which would signify that we want to end the program. So the program is going to display the words list ended. So we're going to declare a number as integer. We're going to repeat. So we're going to loop. And we're going to write, please enter a number. The user is going to put a number in. We're going to write that or output that number to the user. And we're going to continue doing that until we get a value of 0, which is equal to 0. And then we're going to write, list is ended. So we're going to start. We're going to set a variable of number to 0. We're going to create a loop on here. And remember, you just pull the loop over here, just pull it onto the workspace. We're going to loop, and we're going to say, please enter a number. We're going to get the number and make the number variable, whatever that number is. We're going to output that to the user, and then we're going to do a decision tree, and we're going to say, is the number equal to 0? If it is, we're going to end the program, and we're going to say, list is ended, we're done. If not, it's going to just continue to loop around and continue outputting numbers to the user until we're complete. So let's run this. We're going to start, set the number to 0. We're going to enter a number. Let's enter 5. It's going to output, and we're going to see that over on the right-hand side over here. The 5 gets output, and then it's going to ask us to enter another number, and let's do 10. It's going to output that over here. It's going to loop around, and we could just continue putting in numbers. It will continue to output values until we decide to put in a 0. It's not doing anything with those numbers. Later in more advanced Raptor programming, we'll do arrays where we store that information in the program. But in this case, we're just kicking it out to the user. And we're going to put 0. It's going to end the program, and we're done. Okay, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, you can leave a comment below. For my students, you can email me from within the classroom. I hope you have a great day. Remember to stay safe, and also remember to be excellent to each other.